Now the next question says that we have to check whether 6 to the power n can end with the digit 0 where n is a natural number. We have to find out if 6 to the power n ends with a 0. If you expand it, if you multiply it and you find out what the number is, we have to check whether that number would end with 0. Now for any number to end with 0, it has to have a special property. For any number to end with a 0 would mean it has to have some number multiplied by a power of 10, right? Any number multiplied by 10 to the power some number would result in where a is greater than 1. A is greater than or equal to 1. Only in that case you can say with certainty that the number is going to end in 0. Now this number 10 has two prime factors, 2 and 5. So unless and until you have at least 1, 2 and 1, 5, the number can never end in a 0. For any number to end in a 0, it should have at least 1, 2 and 1, 5 together, right? For any number to end in 0, it has to have at least 1, 2 and at least 1, 5. So 6 to the power n is 2 to the power n into 3 to the power n. Why? Because 6 can be written as 2 into 3 to the power n, and you then open the bracket, so you have 2 to the power n into 3 to the power n. Both are prime factors, and from fundamental theorem of arithmetic we know that the order of prime factors might change, but the prime factors are going to remain unique. So the for 6 to the power n, the prime factors would always be 2 and 3. There is no 5 here. And I said that for any number to end in the number 0, it has to have at least 1, 2 and at least 1, 5. There is at least 1, 2, but there is no 5. Hence, this number is not going to end in a 0. So now, in this next question, this again involves the application of HCF and LCM. It says we have to find the largest positive integer that will divide the given three numbers 398, 436 and 542, and they would leave the remainders 7, 11 and 15 respectively in the three cases. So let's see how we do it. Let that number be A. Let A be that number, or we should take B because we are using the Euclid's division lemma also. So let B be that number which when divides 398 leaves a remainder 7. When it divides 436, it leaves a remainder 11, and when it divides 542, it leaves a remainder 15. So from Euclid's division lemma, what do you have? 398 will be b into q1, some quotient, plus a remainder 7. 436 would be b into some other quotient plus remainder 11. And 542 will be b into q3 some quotient plus remainder 15. This is applicable because this is Euclid's division lemma, and this is what we are saying. When b divides 398, you get a remainder 7. When b divides 436, you get a remainder 11. And when b divides 542, you get a remainder 15. So these are the three equations that we get. Now from this equation, what do you get? BQ1 will become, you take 7 to the other side, it becomes 391, right? Here you take BQ2 will be 436 minus 11, that's 425. And here you have BQ3, and this would be equal to 542 minus 15, that's 527. From this given Euclid division lemma, we form these three equations. Now, what do we have to find? We have to find the largest number, right? The largest value of the number B. So, B has to be largest or highest, right? What is the other property of B? Is B for these three numbers, is B a factor of 391? Yes, it is, because B into some integer is equal to 391. Q1, Q2, Q3 are all integers. The quotients are integers. So B has to be an integer. Now, B into something is equal to 391. That means B is a factor of 391. Similarly, B is a factor of 425. And similarly, B is a factor of 527. So, another common property, another property of B is that it is a common factor of 391, 425 and 527. So, for any number that is the highest common factor, what is it called? It's called the HCF. So, B is what? B is, from the equation we figured out, that B is the HCF of 391, 425 and 527. So, to find out the largest integer which will divide 398 to give a remainder 7, which will divide 436 to give a remainder 11 and divide 542 to give a remainder 15 would be the HCF of these three numbers. And to find out the HCF of these three numbers, you can employ any technique. If I do prime factorization, let's see if it goes by 17. It goes. So, it becomes 17 into 23. Similarly, 425. Let's see if it goes by 70. It does. So, it is 17 into 5 square, and 527 would be 17 into 31. And what did I say? The HCF is the lowest power of the common prime. So, the common prime in all these three numbers is 17. The others are not. Although 23, 5 and 31 are prime factors, but they are not common across the three numbers. Only 17 is common. We have to take the lowest power of it. And the lowest power is 1. So, the HCF would be 17. So, 17 is the largest number which will behave this way. When 398 is divided by 17, you should get a remainder 7. When 436 is divided by 17, you should get a remainder 11. And when 542 is divided by 17, you should get a remainder 15. So, this is how you approach this question.